All right, here we are again. I got the engine in the car. I didn't have my phone out here, so I couldn't show you as I was just finished the engine up and dropping it in. It was sort of a headache to get it all aligned. You would think something as simple as this would just drop right in, but man, everything was hitting everything. But I got it all adjusted and I think it's okay. Let me give you a quick tour. Alright, right now I am putting the carburetor together, and not a whole lot to it. Needless to say, when they give you the rebuild kit there is no information on it, but yet they gave you an adjustment for the choke, for the floats. That's all good, but what the fuck do you adjust it at? So I had to go to the book and find the diagram to make sure that I got it together exactly how it needs to go, because there are a couple of things that can be put in, that can be swapped around. So, like, they gave me an extra jet, which doesn't go to this carburetor, which is cool, but those are the kind of things that they do. Maybe it fits another carburetor, I guess, but who knows. But I kept on thinking, what am I missing here? But I am not missing anything. So, but we're good. We'll get it. All right. Let me go show you what I've done up here. Got the engine in, and there you go. She's bolted in. I took the fan apart, the water pump. It was started to rust up in the bearing area here, and then it was rusting a little bit in here because I washed everything, and apparently that it was just loose enough to get a little water in it. So I took it all apart. It's in good shape, but just needed to be greased real good and cleaned. And but I've got it. It's done. These are the weirdest mounts I've ever fooled with. I don't even see what they do. I've tried to figure this thing out, because back here I took these apart, and there's rubber mounts in there. And they do almost nothing. It's almost like it just isolates the engine from the frame, but it will not let it move at all. Nothing here will move. And these springs, they're not doing anything, because the center is bolted down tight. It's got a little thing in there. I put a rubber bushing in there just to isolate it a little bit, but man, I just don't know. I think maybe those aftermarket motor mounts would have probably been the thing to do. But, oh well, I'll just have to see how it goes. I got my distributor rebuilt and all the plugs in. I bought an aftermarket point kit for it. Yeah. This is the... hard to see. It's an aftermarket point kit. Needless to say, putting it together, these points wouldn't even touch a cam. So I had to take and drill the point, weld the point plate up, the holes they had in there, and put the points in to where they could be adjusted, and then re-drill it, and it just... You would think you wouldn't have to do that, but it's just shit made in Japan or China or where the hell it's made. Korea. I don't know, but it's poor. Poor, poor, poor. So anytime you get something aftermarket, you better be prepared to do some work on it. Yeah, you can see it right there. Point plate. because I didn't want to use the original points because they were too, if I burnt one up, you know, I'd have to have a set sitting on the shelf and they're a little weird putting in. And well, these I can go to Napa and get, but it's crazy that you can't buy anything that actually fits. All right, well, this is where we are right now. And I'm gonna put the carburetor on it, and I can't put any linkage on it just yet because I want to put this, figure out what I want to do with the steering column. I think I'm gonna weld, you can see it right here, it's sort of worn. Well, it's not worn, it's rotted away, I think, on the steering. Yeah, you can see how it's rotted. So I think there's a piece of felt in the column that rides there, and the bearing rides here. But I'm going to weld this up anyway. So that's just what I'm going to do today after I get the carburetor on. And then I have to figure out, before I put the steering column in, what I'm going to do with the dash. I don't want to paint the dash with the steering column in. It's too tight in here. So I'm debating about painting it black and then bolting the steering column in. But I don't know. I'm still thinking about it. Because most of the time they paint it the same color as the car. So I have to think about it. I don't know. I might paint it black just to get it done, so I can get that in, because I'm not going to paint the car until it starts to get a little warmer out. But I'll probably start putting the, I'll do all the other stuff. So I'll probably put the floors, get the floors to fit real good and go with them, because they all need to be cleaned up. So do the hood and some other little things. So I might just get all the accessories done and then we'll go from there. All right, well, just want to let you guys know what I'm doing. If anybody gives a shit, nobody's going to see this but me. So, heck, I'll go back and look at it myself and see where I screwed up. All right, so see you later. Bye.